villagers. The master possesses them. It mustn't hurt them. Hurt guards, though. They seek out an object of great power.
Blacksmith's Monday. Old man Willie Green of Gallows Town was awarded Smithy of the Season by our readers. His outstanding casts have produced many intricate and hard-wearing iron goods and sculptures. Willie only uses the finest of metals in his work and is particularly noted for his magnificent busts. Old man Willie was quoted as saying,
"Aye, when I get pumping on me bellows, there's no stopping me. It's all in the rhythm, up and down, up and down. I've always been inspired by the stories of Stanya Ironhewer, the greatest smithy there ever was."
Is held aloft by the flow of water from the fountain. You may have to wait for the next drought. History of Gallowmere, Volume 1. During the dark time that was Gallowmere's not too distant past, it was King Peregrine who thwarted Zerok the Necromancer and his plan to enslave the land. Zerok, once the king's mage, had fallen out of favor with the ruler for conducting outlandish experiments on the bodies of the dead. It was said that deep within Peregrine Castle, the dead were restless. The dead are to be honored, not kept as the playthings of alchemists, declared King Peregrine as he banished Zerok from the castle. All of Zerok's living dead were routed out and destroyed. Zerok, being an unforgiving soul, went into hiding and vowed to wreak his revenge on the king. History of Gallowmere, Volume 2. Rumors of ill-doing and dark deeds abounded through the land of Gallowmere. It was whispered that Zerok had employed the aid of shadowy demons to help build a vast castle. Under the cover of night, Zerok's dark army spilled forth from the corrupt haven. The army marched south across the Silver Mountains and through the Silver Woods. Soon afterwards, even the Pumpkin Lands belonged to Xerox. The folk of Gallows Town cried out for help. Save us, good King Peregrine. Retaliation was swift and violent. King Peregrine's forces, led by the brave Sir Fortescue, drove Xerox's army back from Gallows Town. Oh, there was much rejoicing, but the war was not yet over. History of Gallomir, Volume 3. News that Xerox's army had now taken the floodlands caused much concern. From this vantage point, Xerox could march west to take the Enchanted Forest. This sacred place would prove a bitter defeat if it fell into the hands of the evil sorcerer. It was Sir Dan Fortescue who once again led the king's militia to rid the demon host from the land. Yet the evil wizard was cunning and had prepared an ambush. Titanic battle ensued, of which history has never seen the like. It is said that the day would have gone to Xerox, but for the skill and valor of one man. Fortescue led the charge deep into the massed ranks of the undead, felling Xerox's bodyguard, the fearful Lord Cardock, and before finally succumbing to his own mortal wounds, slew the traitorous sorcerer with a mighty sweep of his sword. History of Gallomir, Volume 4. The forces of Evil were destroyed, but at a terrible price. None but a handful of the king's militia returned from that field. Gallomir lost a whole generation of young men that day, including Canny Tim, the legendary crossbowman, and Fortescue's second in command, who fell in the first volley of arrows. Xerox's body was never found, though if it lies unmourned in an unmarked grave, then no one in Gallomir would shed a tear. The shadow demons that had fallen under Xerox's banner were unnatural creatures that did not belong in the world of mortal men. The king declared that they be banished, entombed under the pure earth of the Enchanted Earth. Imprisoned within an impregnable box of the king's design, the demons were buried deep underground. Their tomb was sealed with a magical device that has since come to be known as the Shadow Artifact. Heroes from History, a retrospective. Chapter 1. In addition to being the strongest man who ever lived, Stanier Ironhewer was unsurpassed in his skill as a blacksmith. He was equally happy pounding on his anvil at home as he was Tourist's Guide to Gallomir, Part 1. The land of Gallomir is a wondrous land of breathtaking sights and adventure. Tourist's Guide to Gallomir, Part 2. If it's mystery you're looking for, then to whom it may concern, I must make haste, for Xerox's men will be here within the hour. I have taken the crucifix from the church. It is the key to a key. I used the cross to make the attached cast. Then I had it destroyed. It is my hope that this cast falls into the hands of a just and good hero. Signed, the town mayor. Thank you. Bust of Mr. Shanks, landlord of the Troll's Head. To clean the statue, lower the pedestal. A crucifix once stood here, but the mayor took it. Find a replacement and see how the church should really look.
Comrades, tear this place apart. If we don't find the shadow artifact, Lord Zarak will have us mucking out the demons for the next millennium.
You'll pay the toll!
Dear sir and madam, on my travels across Galamir, I have come across many mysterious and enchanting finds. However, that which filled me with deepest dread was discovery of the tomb of the shadow demons. The key to their dank prison, the mysterious shadow artifact, is now in my possession. Yours fearfully, the town mayor. Capture that greedy profiteer, the town mayor. Take him to the asylum dungeons. Give the fat boy a good going over. Locate the shadow artifact. Bring me back something nice.
Forth like a supernatural yo-yo. Maybe the master will make it harder to find those magic egg cups. Oh.
Hey, Mr. Fortesque! I want to talk with you! If this Zorak's so bad, why'd you get to go back? Why'd you of all people, Fortesque? He should be I, Blood Monath, Skull Cleaver. When I lived, always I had a pile of slain strewn around me. You spend most of your time organizing and changing of the guard and playing croquet with the king. Still, I lend you my axe. You swing her, you throw her. She thirsts for a slaughter as much as I. Drink deep of demon blood, my proud beauty.
shall enter. The shadow demons are entombed within, separated from the world of goodness and light until the earth cracks open. No one, not even the Dark Lord Zarek, can release them without the shadow artifact. Leave now, or share their doom.
Sir Dan, you must take the Shadow Demon Talisman. It is an unholy relic, but it may allow you to progress through Shadow Demon territory.
Once again, the shadow demons are wreaking havoc across the land, and it's all thanks to you. The single most destructive and wretched creatures in the history of the world, and you've given them an early parole. They will be heading for the ruins of King Peregrine's castle. Galamir is doomed.
Thank you. Thank you.
Herr Fortescue. You are back on the battlefield, yeah? This is good. People say to me, Sturmgard, what do you think of this sword or that axe? But I say to them, nein! Modern warfare is a question of science, the science of shields! I think maybe you should take my shield, yeah? It is magic, Herr Fortescue. Some say it is better to have a magic sword than a magic shield, but I say to you that this is rubbish! So long as you use it properly, the shield will make you invincible!
This is the Garden of Xerok. Nothing here is as it first seems. To leave this maze, you must first seek out the one called Jack of the Green.
Fortescue. My name is Jack of the Green. I am the master of riddles, and this maze is my domain. You are free to leave, but only once you've answered four riddles. Puzzles so fiendishly difficult, so perplexingly complex, that no man has ever solved them. Ha ha ha. Now, try my first riddle. At night they come without being fetched. By day they are lost. Without being stolen.
Thank you.
Well done, Sir Knight. But my star riddle was but a trifle. I always like to begin with an easy one. Return hither. You will not find my next conundrum so simple. I live for laughter. I live for the crowd. Without it, I am nothing. I live for laughter. I live for the crowd. Without it, I am nothing.
Show the clown you care by surrounding him with smiles. We'll be right back.
Yes, it was a clown. Very clever, I'm sure. Return in haste, Sir Knight, for I wish to see the despair on your face when you hear my next cryptic puzzler. Face like a tree, skin like the sea, a great beast I be, yet vermin frighten me. Did you spot my bluff? I pretended that riddle was hard, but in truth it was obviously an elephant. This time, however, I almost pity you. The answer to my next vexing enigma has eluded the finest minds of a whole generation. Come to me. I tolerate the moon and stars. I can't abide the sun. Banish me with torchlight and you'll see me turn and run. Outrageous as it seems, my vast intellect has been matched by your badly decomposed brain. Return at once and I shall give you your prize. Grant you free passage through my maze. Find your own way out.
Oh, Danielle, I've got something here I can give you, but I've no idea what it is. You fancy a little gamble, like?
Thank you. Why, Hecum, I'm glad to see you. That zealot tried to force me to hand over the shadow artifact. He means to release the demons from their tomb under the enchanted forest. But I said to him, I said, you can't touch me, you lanky windbag. I'm the mer. Aye, that told him. But then he had me locked up in here with all these nutters. Oh, it's been terrible. I haven't managed to get a word of sense out of anyone in weeks. Right. Well, I'll see myself out, thanks. You have a good look around, lad. Zarek's left some stuff lying about that I think you might find useful.
You'll be back pushing all daisies by now. Eh, I have something here for you. You like it very much? You want?